Okay, tonight, this is our first lecture on the anatomy aspect of this class. And what we talked about last week was we did proportion using our head measurements. So I guess the natural place to start is the skull. Because we're going to use the same kind of measurements. And the basic structure that we use is based on a cube, or a 5i cube, or a 5i square. An I, as you know, of course, when I'm talking about an I shape, what I'm going to do here is draw a 5 things resemble an eye. An eye actually is slightly smaller than the orbit, which would probably be about like this on the skull. Maybe even a little larger. So that what you end up with is a basic measurement that's an approximation of what an eye is, but the eye is not really shown fully, you have all the flesh over it, and it ends up being a lot smaller. Thing like that. So the eye measurement is actually an eyeball, is what we're talking about. And so what we're going to be doing is making a square to begin with. The idea of, there's two ideas actually of how you look at a figure, and the reason we start with the head. It's because the head is actually what gives all of the posture and movement to the figure. For instance, if the figure looks this way, generally what's going to happen is part of the torso is going to turn that way. It's highly probable that someone will stand like this and look as far as they can this way without something happening. And so that's why the head. Not only do we start drawing with the head, but that's where the way the head is looking. Now, there's two ways that we describe that, or most artists describe that. One of them is position, and the other is aspect. These two words, very different. The position refers to the position of the model. I mentioned this in the last time, and I'll talk about this over and over again, that if the model is looking straight ahead, that's the model's position. If the model's looking to the right, or leaning over, that's the model's, that looks pretty forlorn, that's the model's position. Aspect is your point of view, which could be anything, because everybody's going to be all around the room. My point of view is now a three-quarter back view, where most of your view is going to be a three-quarter front to a front view. So that's the aspect. Now, if the head is that important, then how are we going to determine which way the head's looking? And in this class, the first thing we want to do is figure out how to determine that. But I was going to take if this is a ball, like a golf ball, and we can take any little ball, and if I took a ball and drew a line all the way around it in one direction, and then I take a line and draw all around the circumference of this ball, I perfectly was able to do that, and then I did another line perfectly all the way around the ball, perpendicular to the first one, but all around the circumference, and I was looking straight at the ball, I would see two curved lines that look like that. That would approximate, well, let's stay with this for a minute. Now, if I was to turn that slightly, and I just turned it to the left, I'd end up with that. And if I was to turn it to the left, well, let's say I turn it to the right, and I look up, it's going to look like that. And right away, that gives me really good idea of the position of the model's head. And also the aspect of how I'm looking at it in this direction here, either the model's looking up or I'm looking up at the model who's looking straight ahead. So now the next question is how does that relate to the skull? And if I see overdraw a little bit, I want to get down. Well, just trying to stay down here. We start with a circle without measuring yet. But the whole idea here is what's going to happen, and I'm sure you've seen this before, a lot of you have taken some classes, and usually the head, the fat head is looking to the right, slightly down. So it ends up with two cylinders. And what you end up here is basically what that showed you is the back of the cranium here, points one head, and the other circle is attached to the front. And so then you end up with, right where these two intersect, if I was to intersect from the front, right here, is generally considered the brow line. Or what we call the superorbital, which is this, and I'll talk about that in a minute, which is this bump right above the orbits here, which is hidden by your eyebrows most of the time. And so, the idea of the position here is I'm drawing these curves again, this line here, and I say, well, the model is looking down. So I'll draw that halfway mark, which is this one, in a down curve, which is like this. And then the center, and I'm always going from the top, I can actually use this. Most skeletons are actually hung from a wire. I'm just thinking of doing that because I can't really pick this guy up. And move around the way I want to, just a little unusual thing. But this being the top right here. And so if I make a little dot up there, right here, here, and it's going to come through the middle, I have a three-quarter front view. What I'm doing is I'm thinning like this, or putting one right here, it's a straight on. If your position, position the model looking right at you, and you're standing right in front of the model looking at the face, your distance. So that this line is right down the middle. Right down the middle of that. So now we've got a line going this way, and a line going this way. And so what you have now is a way to indicate position and aspect without using anatomy, but in a way, this is a very good way to deal with gesture of the head. Because what we've got here, what happens, and I mentioned that right here, I mentioned that superorbital, which I'll draw and talk about again, it's kind of right above the sinus. Mm-hmm. But what happens is I end up with a shadow over here. And so a lot of times what you'll see artists do is they will make a quick shadow across the center, maybe a slight indication for nose like that. And what you got right away is some of the main planes of the face and the direction with which you're going. All you have to do is move this nose to the left or the right. You can curve this orbital a little bit. So that in gesture, when one of the most important things you're looking for is the vision of the head. Because that indicates the torso twist. It's also going to indicate, as I said, we talked about briefly, two landmark planes or directions of travel. Didn't talk about the top girdle as much, but it's right there. The one we talked about the other day was right here. So that when the model stands on one leg or the other, this is going to tilt. It's right off of these two points right here. Just like me, last stand here, and I stand and put all my weight on the left foot. That the pelvis tilts this way. And for me to compensate, you know, see, I have to hang on to this guy because what's going to happen to me is I need to go this way to compensate. So the pelvis is going this way, the shoulder line is going to go the other way. So that I don't have to go this way, or this, or this way. The thing about this guy is I can't tilt that because it's on a little stick. So they're standing right up there. So